Well, here we go. We're at the the Dusty Nostril gravel race. It's a it's an 8-hour relay. You can do single person, two person, or four person. We're doing the two person event. Let's go over here to Sean.
Good morning.
Sean, how many of these have you done?
This is my first one. Thanks very much.
Okay.
Inaugural.
But yeah. He's a veteran Ironman and stuff like that. Look at the legs on the kid. He's ready to go. Those legs don't scare you. Those legs don't scare you. You've never been to a bike race before. But so we're set up here. I got the, I don't know how you say it, chaise lounge. Chaise long, like the song. Anyway, yeah, we're about to do the riders meeting and then we're gonna go. It's a 90% chance of rain. So there's a 10% chance it'll be dusty. Anyway, this is gonna be fun.
Just because the fresh gravel that's out there, you guys will love that. There's 750 meters of fresh gravel, guys.
Thing here, look at Sean here. He's getting ready to go. He's his plan was that we were going to draw straws or rock, paper, scissors, who goes first, but I decided he's going first. It was this whole thing was his idea. Sean, good luck.
Here we go.
All right, Sean's lined up here for the start of this thing. Let's go see what he's feeling here.
And of course, the East Perth Town Council and the North Perth Town Council, as we're approaching 2 minutes. Attention riders, 2 minutes to the start. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and away you go. Good luck to one and all as you roll out in the first ever Dusty Nostril, brought to you by Cycle Waterloo.
Oh, I never thought about this part, but this two-person team, basically you're alone all day, so this is, he's on his first lap and on board already. It's gonna be a long day. All right, here comes Sean, first lap. That's him.
Dinosaurs Endurance.
Hey, buddy. In a hurry. How
awesome,
was it?
Awesome. It was
any
great.
Tips? Any tips?
It's pretty flat.
Right.
Have a good ride.
Hey, everybody, say hi.
There he is.
Dude, right. Right, way within yourself. It's going to be a long day.
Okay. Awesome, man. I know. I tear the thread.
Yeah.
It's okay.
Just ride within yourself, man. Just ride within yourself.
Cheers. Thanks.
Good job, Jeffy.
Well, that was lap one of hopefully not many. Sean's heading out for number two. That ended up being 42 minutes. Tried to ride within myself there totally, but I don't know if 42 minutes is fast or not. I caught a dude ahead of me and just drafted. I told him that's what we should have been doing the whole time. Why not just draft? The first lap, there was a group of seven. Six of them were doing the solo. They're averaging like 36K an hour. Man, straights are a lot longer than I thought they were gonna be. 21 kilometers, I thought I was getting close. Took a look at my watch and it was only 21 minutes. So it's gonna be a long day. It's lap one. I have an 8-hour period, so Sean's out there now. I'm gonna relax and stretch.
There he is, chipper pace across the line.
I killed myself to catch that group. Oh man,
so
then I just sat on their wheel.
That's fine, guys.
Perfect, go find someone, go find a wheel.
All right, bud. Can you get the salt or electrolytes thing out for next lap?
Yeah, I can. The Rhino Power electrolytes, you mean? Sponsor plug. All right, well, we're two laps in now. Rode well within myself on the first one. The second one, I think you start feeling better, but you don't want to fool yourself and just start crushing it. So I think I rode within myself. I was a couple minutes faster than the first one, but there was a group ahead of me. A girl in the bright pink and some other guy, they were working together and I could see him way out there, like, I don't know, 750 meters ahead of me. So I worked hard to catch him. Finally caught him on the G2G part. Sat in behind them. She seemed fine with it, but the dude, some Guelph rider guy, didn't seem overly thrilled. Didn't really give me the time of day, but appreciate the draft. And if it was any longer, I was gonna take my turn out front. But anyway, didn't hit the finish line, so. So that's two, and I'm hoping that's halfway. I'm really hoping that's halfway. So anyway, Sean's out there now and he's going pretty fast, so I don't have a whole lot of time. I wish he was going slower.
Grime Trials in there, Scott Hubacher, Sean Bossy, and Dalen Merritt.
Solo guys, averaging like 36K an hour, probably faster now working together. Pretty impressive. They're almost a lap ahead of us. That tells you something. They're that fast or we're that slow? A bit of both. All right, so we're three laps in. Noticeably slower on that one. Starting to hurt a little bit. I moved the seat. The seat was too far back. It's a borrowed bike. The seat was too far back, so I was really straining. I see my hamstrings were super tight every time I'd come in, so that seems to have solved that problem, but it didn't make me go faster. I don't think I've got enough long rides in, but we'll keep going. Sean's out there. I told him I'm going noticeably slower, and he said so is he, but he's still going pretty fast, so you don't get a long enough break. I really want to just sort of sit here for longer. I went in the pool, though, so I think that might be key, kind of washed off in the pool. Get the salt off, kind of rejuvenate you. It's not exactly too cold, but certainly refreshing. We'll see if this pays off. There's a girl that's got a Cycling Waterloo partner, and he is smoking fast, so Sean's out there trying to battle him, and then she leaves a few minutes ahead of me, so the whole way I can see her pink jersey ahead of me, and I just, it's kind of like a carrot, but it's also kind of killing me, so that time I wasn't quite able to catch her, and there's three dudes out front doing the solo event, and they came flying by me, solo, 8 hours, they came flying by me, so I thought, okay, I'll draft these guys down the G to G trail. I was able to hang on for, I don't know, maybe a kilometer, if that, I don't know, but they're in a nice little echelon. There wasn't a whole lot left in the back left, so I was doing what I could, but they spit me out the back, and I was on my own. These guys are doing 8 hours of that, so kudos to those dudes, but I don't know what time it is, but hopefully we're over halfway, and I don't know how long this next one's going to take, and the rain is kind of, seems to be starting a little more solidly, so we'll see how that plays out here, too. Might be time to throw the fender on. Anyway, we'll see how this goes. Oh, man. Well, that was lap four. Oh, I pretty much had nothing left, nothing in the legs. And I had to stop. It started raining just as I got out there, too. And the sweat, a little hair. The rain just makes the sweat come down into your eyes, and I must have stopped four or five times. Literally, I'd take my helmet off, wipe things down with whatever I had. The little things on your gloves. And then the race car came by, and he's like, "You okay?" I'm like, "Yeah, I'm good. I just can't see through my sweat." And he goes, "Oh, I got rags in the back." So yeah, he gave me a rag from the trunk. So that helped a little bit. But man, just with the rain, it just pours down your eyes. You're just blinded. But not only that, my legs are toast. Not enough miles in the legs for this kind of thing. I've done four laps. It's certainly not the bike's fault. The weather's just a little nasty. This guy keeps flying by me. So Sean's gone out. We'll decide what we're gonna do after that, because I don't know if I have another lap in me, or we both ride together and just take the GoPro and goof off, but we'll see how it goes. Atta boy!
Big smile, the big grin. Endurance Dinosaurs.
Well, that's Sean holding it together for the Endurance Dinosaurs. This guy right here, he buckled. Yeah, I don't know, man. That was, yeah. Anyway, that's it. Time's up. We won't get another lap in under the time, so we're toast. Good job by Sean. Go talk to him, see how he feels. Well, you busted out two laps to finish this thing. How'd that feel?
Oh, it was not bad, actually.
As soon as you went out there, the rain stopped. I'm like, oh, man, I could have struggled through another lap, but I didn't.
I was tired.
Boy, man, you held it together for the Endurance Dinosaurs.
Yeah, teamwork, eh?
Probably secured our number two spot.
Maybe fifth.
I mean, in our age group.
Yeah. Oh, I don't know. I didn't even look, actually.
It's only three of us.
Oh, okay. All right. Yeah!
Well, how was it there?
Get us both on there.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
How was it? Was it
it was good.
Last lap muddy, or what was it like?
It was actually dried up. It was not bad at all, actually.
What?
And no wind. The wind died down. I'm like, this is going to be easy now, so...
I was in the pool.
Yeah, did you go in?
Twice. I'm in the pool twice.
Oh, I gotta go in there too then.
Alright. Alright, that's it.
Backstage.
Oh, I said her name again. Oh, that's why he's cranky there, sir. Oh, no, they want it.
You guys are
top up.
Alright, where's everybody going?
You guys going top step?
Oh, that's why he didn't want me drafting. All right, hey, well, Sean, hey, get up beside me, man. Oh, what's going on here?
Trying to
keep up. We're walking. It's a walk and talk.
All right, walk and talk.
All right, buddy. So we just finished second in the old one of the old guy categories.
I know, surprise.
You held, like I said, held the team together. Did maple, those extra couple laps.
We got some maple syrup.
Got some maple syrup. Yes. The course was sweet. I like that. It was good.
Oh yeah, it was awesome.
Dusty. I'm under train, unfortunately, but
me too. That's what the cramps are for. Keeps you alive, right? It reminds you that.
So you're next year, I think, like we were saying, I think a team of four makes a hell of a lot of sense.
Either that or training more beforehand. So
well, also, we're here doing a team race. You spent the entire day alone.
True. Yeah, like I guess
if we I go out. You sit there for 40 minutes while you're out riding. And it's like, oh, okay. There he is. There he is again. Then I go out and ride.
Yeah.
By myself.
But here we are now having a good time.
So. Having a good time. We got the maple syrup. So yeah. Yeah. Waterloo Cycling Club or whatever it's called.
Yep. Cycles Waterloo.
Cycles Waterloo. Yeah. And it was so good times.
Represents 519.
Yeah, the 519 was there. Yo. All right. Well, hey, that's gonna do it. Time for a massage. And that'll do it. Thanks, Sean.
Cheers.